Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and today we're gonna create some insanely creative transitions inside Adobe Premiere Pro with the help of the brand new Dell XPS 17 and its NVIDIA RTX graphics card inside. So thank you Dell and NVIDIA for sponsoring today's episode. And now that we have this bad boy, let's create some transitions. And the first one is a little bit inspired by a shot seen in Umbrella Academy. Basically, what you want to do is take a shot from a tripod where you walk and pretend like you're transitioning into another time. Then change the scene and perhaps some lights, but keep the camera on the same point. Then try and do that exact same movement again at the same place. And you can mark the floor to make that easier for you. And that's all we need. So now let's fire up Adobe Premiere Pro. Place your first shot in the timeline and the second one on top, then trim the top clip and sync it with the bottom clip so that you already have this jump cut transition. Now with the top one selected, head over to the opacity property and take the pen tool to draw a small long shaped mask over yourself. Then create a keyframe for the mask pad, go a little bit forward in time and open up that mask, but make sure that you somehow follow the lines of your background. Then go a little bit forward again and now open up the mask completely. And now it already seems like a new world is opening up. And of course, feather it a bunch. All right, we've got most of the editing done. The last steps are gonna be a few effects to make it look a little bit better. And here is where I'd love to talk about the NVIDIA RTX 2060 GPU, which sits inside the Dell XPS 17 laptop. So video editing has always been a very processor intensive task, and it still is today, but it's slowly changing. If you go into the effects library of Premiere Pro and select this icon, you'll see all the effects that are GPU accelerated. And that are actually a lot of effects. And we can create every transition today with such an effect. For instance, I'm going to drag the lens distortion over to an adjustment layer above my transition. Now the line on top stays yellow, which means that it doesn't require rendering, as the NVIDIA GPU is able to do that for you in real time. Now NVIDIA and Adobe have been actually working together for many years now to make this possible, because after all, performance comes down a lot to software. And like we've seen in one of the previous updates of Premiere, we can also now export utilizing the NVIDIA graphics card more, which gives us blazing fast speeds. So over time with updates, I'm pretty sure that we'll start to see more and more of these GPU accelerated functionalities. Also, if you already have an NVIDIA RTX GPU, then check in your GeForce Experience app that Studio Drivers over there here is selected, because these are different than game drivers and will give you better stability and performance for creative tasks like working in 3D applications or video editing tools like Premiere. So yeah, definitely check that out, but let's get back to the transition now. I'm going to animate the curvature of the lens distortion effects from 0 to around minus 20 and then back to 0, which is gonna give us the following results. Now we're slowly getting there. The last thing that I want to do is apply the VR chromatic aberrations effect to the adjustment layer. And this is an accelerated effect as well, which makes working with it super fun, as we can just change the parameters all in real time. So basically what I'd like to do now is simply animate the three aberration channels from 0 to something random for all three and then go back to 0. And that gives you an awesome transition between two time zones. You know, actually, I was making these transitions quite often when I was still making after movies. Instead of showing the guests entering the event and going to their tables, I would make like one shot of the empty hall and then another from the same angle when everyone sat at their tables, and then I would make this glitch transition in between and have this cool glitch transition time shift thingy. It was pretty cool. All right, that was probably the longest transition of them all. The next ones are gonna be a whole lot shorter. So let's continue with the bird transition. Now what I've got right here is a shot of a bird flying through the air, and that is actually a stock clip from Storyblocks. The second shot I took myself, which is simply a tilt down from the sky. And Premiere Pro plays that bird shot in a timeline and somewhere in the middle when that bird is covering completely the sky, I will add the second shot on top of there. You can already go ahead and add a cross dissolve on the top clip so that it fades over into the other. Now duplicate that bottom clip to the top and trim it so that it starts with the one below. Now with it selected, I'm going to animate a rough mask around the bird, and this will make it easier for the next step when I'm going to apply the ultra key effect to it. Again, an accelerated effect, meaning that I can just select the blue sky and easily pull a key in real time. And that's pretty much it. Here we go, a simple bird transition that looks pretty awesome. On to the next one, which is going to be a camera going through a window. So basically you take a shot of you walking towards a window. Then you have to go to the other side of the window and continue your travel from there. That's it, so fire up Premiere again and place the two shots next to each other in a timeline. We'll first match the two clips together by bringing the second clip a track higher and trimming it over the first clip. Set the opacity to 50 and use the motion controls to align the two clips. When done with that, set the opacity back to 100 and then trim the clip and place it back next to the other in the timeline. Now to get rid of that black border, add an adjustment layer over the entire edit and apply the transform effect to it. With that, we can scale up and reposition everything. And that should already give you a smooth transition. But now, let's create the illusion that we pass through the glass. And for this, I'm going to create a new color mat, doesn't matter which color. Place it over the transition and add a cross dissolve to both ends. On this color mat, apply the ramp effect, and we're going to change the two colors to something bluish or slightly green. Then change the opacity blending mode to overlay, and this already creates that glass color. Next up, duplicate this color mat a track higher, delete the ramp effect from it, and apply the VR fractal noise. And play around with the contrast and the brightness to get some light differences. And finally, increase the scale a bit under the transform to make sure that those light stains are big enough. And this brings us to the final step. Add an adjustment layer to the very top and apply the lens distortion to it. We're going to animate the curvature again from 0 to around minus 20 and back to 0. And that's it. Now I've been making all of these transitions on the Dell XPS 17 and it's been going super smooth. This right here is a workstation laptop with top-notch hardware like an Intel i7 8-core CPU, 32 gigs of RAM, and of course the NVIDIA RTX 2060. So this laptop could replace a desktop if you're more interested in having that portability of a laptop. But what I'm actually the most excited about sits on the inside, and that is the touchscreen. I always thought it was a gimmick, but it actually makes editing or just working on the laptop in general a whole lot faster. Definitely if you're not a big fan of touchpads like I am, but I don't feel like I need an external mouse now anymore with the touchscreen, so that is definitely pretty awesome. All right, transition number 4, which is actually something that I created several times in my travel video when I visited Iceland. So let's work with two shots from that video. Here's a simple drone shot. You can also just work with any other landscape shots. And next I have a shot of some wild water, but this big rock right here sits in the foreground and that is gonna be a very important element. Place the two shots next to each other in the timeline and on two different tracks. For the top clip, I will trim it out a little bit, add a cut, then right click on the clip and go to frame hold options, and from a dialog box choose hold on out points. Then on that hold clip, I'm going to draw a mask around the rock and when done, feather it a little bit as it's out of focus. I would now like to animate this using the transform effect, but in order to do that, we first have to nest the clip by right clicking on it. Now apply the transform effect and animate the position so that the rock flies in from the bottom. And you can of course also let it fly in from the sides or from the top depending on where your foreground object is at. Finally, disable the use composition shutter angle and set one of your own like 180 degree to get natural motion blur from your animation. Next up, we're gonna do the exact same on the drone shot. Apply the transform effect to it, but first scale it up a little bit so that we have some room to animate the position as well. So now it feels like the camera tilts down, revealing the next shot. Again, set a custom shutter angle and that's pretty much it. If you like, you could build further on this idea, but I like the simplicity of just the cut between the two clips the most. And that brings us to the last one, which is gonna be a door transition. Yes, inspired by Ben TK, who sometimes does that in his travel videos. However, we are going to do it a little bit simpler using Premiere Pro. What you want to do is shoot a door, and if you like, you can bring movement into your shot as well, and then some other random shot of your choice. In Premiere, place that door shot in the timeline, and at the point where we'd like to start the transition, we'll place the playhead, then right click and choose frame hold. What I wanna do now is open the door, but when I use the basic 3D effect to do that, it will rotate around the middle of the clip and not at the door. So to fix that, I'm first going to right click on the clip and nest it. Then open up the nested sequence and apply the VR projection effect to it. And with that effect, we can reposition the side of the door so that it comes in the middle of the frame. And you can use guides or the safe margins to help you with that. Then go back to the main sequence, and for starters, we'll duplicate the nested sequence, and one of them will be the opening of the door. But first, let's disable the output of track number 2 and use the VR projection again to push the bottom nested clip back in place. Then enable track number 2 again and apply the crop effect to it. You wanna adjust the crop so that it sits around the door. When we now apply the basic 3D effect to this clip, you'll see that we can open and close the door. However, it doesn't sit on the right place yet. So what I'm gonna do is apply the transform effect to reposition it back. When the door opens, we can still see that door from the bottom clip. So on that bottom clip, we're going to draw a mask around the door. And when done with that, make sure to enable invert. And that's how we can now open up a door. A lot of work to open a door. I know, a lot of preparations, but now comes the cool part as we'll transition through that door. I'm already going to make an animation of that door opening up. Now let's select everything and nest that together so that we can work on a single clip. Place your second shot underneath that nest, and now it's just a simple matter of applying the transform effect to both clips and animating it in such a way that we zoom into the door and that the other clip sits inside. That second clip starts small, and then it also goes back to normal size. And I actually also animated the rotation property, as that made it easier since a horizontal door fits better within the horizontal video. And that's pretty much it. It's a little bit of work, but it looks very cool. And those were my 5 insanely creative transitions. I hope that you've learned something new today and enjoyed this tutorial. A big thanks to Dell and Nvidia for sponsoring today's episode. If you would like to learn more about the brand new Dell XPS 17, then you can find a link to it in the description down below. But more important, thank you for watching, and as always, stay creative.
So we've just received this new microphone from Deity. And it's super awesome because it's double-sided. So that means that I can talk on either side of the microphone and I'm sounding super crisp. So it's the ideal microphone for vloggers or for interviews. Awesome, right? I love it already.